Hello guys, welcome. We're here and ready for WePlay Season 3 continuing. We did miss out on a couple of games this morning as they were postponed and moved around, shuffled in the schedule, but we're ready for tornado.rox against HellRaisers, a cracker from the CIS region, followed up by a couple more games this evening. Wombat against Liquid from EU West, as well as Samurai Champloo against Prius later on tonight. But joining me right now is Mottpax. And for some reason... Oh my goodness.
Hello.
Gracious me. You are incredibly loud.
Oh, I'm very loud now, am I?
I've had to turn you like almost all the way down. What on earth?
Why is Skype moving my thing automatically? It's just Skype things.
Goodness gracious, that rip ears. Is your mic boosted?
No, it shouldn't be.
Weird.
No.
Same
settings still. Yeah.
Same settings for me as when we cast the other day. Interesting. Very, very interesting. Ladies and gentlemen, this is why we shouldn't be using Skype anymore. But we'll continue, because the draft is going, and Heroes being picked up and banned out, and tornado.rox get their hands on that Oracle first up. HellRaisers, Nature's Prophet, Witch Doctor. No Zeus. No Zeus for either of the teams just yet. That hero, you know, paired up with a Furion, paired up even with just the Oracle.
Remaining.
They shout a hell of a lot of damage.
5 seconds
so
remaining.
I'm just taking a look at this. Okay, I think we're good. Is it? Am I dying, killing everyone, or are we all right?
Reserve time. I think we're okay. It's picking up a little bit of background. Like usually, it's because I'm comparing to what you usually sound like, and it's like perfect. I don't have to touch anything usually when I cast with you. But
yeah, I can kind of hear myself in your background. Are you on the other studio?
I'm in the usual studio that I'm always in.
Oh, all right then. Oh, who knows? Well, what can you do?
Gremlins.
So what do we got here? We got that Nature's Prophet. We got the Witch Doctor, the Oracle. We got the Faceless Void. The Vengeance gone. Don't worry about that. We are still looking for the. All right, there she is. So the Death Prophet to go with the Faceless Void. Can't be having that. So HellRaisers will ban that out. And now we're left with Invoker and the Old Dirty. It would be the two big players, I think. Who else? Who else is missing here?
Zeus,
maybe for the Prophet.
Zeus, Batrider. I think those are the kind of usual suspects, as it were. But it's kind of awkward, you know. You could look at number of heroes. There's still a couple of annoying little supports out there, and Drow Ranger is going to be the ban out actually from tornado.rox, a hero that has been utilized by a fair amount of CIS teams. We've seen Pasha pick it up a couple of times over on Vega. And I can't remember who they were playing against before that, because Vega played against someone, and they played against the Drow, and then they picked Drow in the next game. It was just this chain of Drow pickage. It's HR, Morphling, more global power, and they ban out the Ancient Apparition. Just stop that ice blast.
Speaking of global power, I was noticing coming into this that one thing that rocks are always sure to do is they often do ban out the IO themselves. In fact, almost all their games, they kind of make it a big priority. And, well, similarly... When it comes to HR, teams do often ban it out up against them. So I wonder if maybe they're thinking about something here for HellRaisers, but going into the Morphling first, they might not be going back to it. But something like a tiny IO or something could have been kind of nice here for HellRaisers, sneaking that in the second phase.
I'm thinking about it right now. What do we go for? Faceless Void Oracle. Quite often with the Faceless Void, you know, he does decently in the offlane. He can farm jungle with Iron Talon, get himself up to level 6, but... Actually having a combo hero to go with it, Enchantress could be that hero. Impetus into the Chronosphere, you know, you can't really understate how much damage an Enchantress can do once she hits level 6. And having that setup, having the offensive or defensive mechanism of Chronosphere from the Faceless Void, can give Enchantress a decent time, but she is kind of walking into this ticking time bomb of Morphling. Because once he gets his E-Blade, Enchantress is just food. For the water-based being.
10 seconds remaining. That's true. They don't have anything to really deal with the Morphling yet either. Obviously, her high damage can be kind of brutal in the same way with that Impetus, like the pure damage cutting through the Morphling with his really high armor. Not too many teams drafting up the Elder Titan or something like that to deal with that these days. So I don't think he has to worry about that. But they have a little bit of a duality kind of thing going on there between the two of them. I like the Oracle with the Enchantress. That's going to be pretty intense. I'd actually... kind of like to see the OD still come out here for tornado.rox if they want to squeeze that into their draft. Like, perhaps if this ends up being a support enchantress or even a safelane enchantress mid OD. I think it'll be very good. Oracle works extremely well with the World Devourer and the enchantress, and you know, well, like, what are you gonna do up against that much damage, honestly, and all being at range to be used with Chronosphere too.
That's true. HellRaisers, Illidan standing in for them. His Morphling has been pretty on point recently, apart from that one game the other day where they were getting pushed in high ground and Illidan had this E-Blade. He had E-Blade Lincoln Sphere like 27 minutes or something. He was going around killing everyone. Then he died 3 times in a row just from, you know, silly little errors, getting hexed up by the enemy OD. It did get a little bit messy, but the rest of it was fine, you know? His laning play is pretty superb. His running around killing people play is always on point. It's just sometimes you have to really mesh with the team to know what's up and where you need to be. Well,
give me this Invoker, man. Like, just pick it. Like, let's go. Is it just not something that HR want to do? It seems so good right here. In fact, they've only picked it twice, so it looks like it's a hero that they, in fact, don't pick. Banning it 15 times so far this patch. So it seems like it would be great with their lineup, doesn't it? Like, the Nature's Prophet, the Morphling, it fits in pretty well into both of those. It gives you a lot of range outside the Chronosphere to help allies, potentially damaging the Faceless Void or disabling him as well. And instead, it will be the Puck, though. So they're going to be offering a lot of control here. And works kind of like Chronosphere with the Witch Doctor in terms of letting you set up a nice little death ward. They don't really have anything at range if Chronosphere is down to even deal with the Witch Doctor as well. So they're going to answer back with the Invoker themselves. And that's a great hero to have comboed up with Faceless Void as well.
I think with HellRaisers, it was more about looking at the laning stage and being worried about Invoker just getting trashed. Because if Enchantress comes in with a creep, if there's an OD mid, Invoker is just going to get shut down so heavily. Witch Doctor, not the best roaming support, you know, can help by moving in with the casks and throwing them out. But it would put a lot of pressure on that mid lane, and that's also taking pressure away from the Faceless Void.
Yeah.
You don't really want to give him a free time. The Puck, Slippery Little Devil, going to do decently in lane. Not really too susceptible to ganks either. With the Sven banned out, Tornado Rox, their final hero here, the safe lane carry for them. What could we actually look at? A lot of the usual suspects have been actually banned out. Ember Spirit is still there. Ember plus Chrono is pretty nice. 5 seconds remaining.
Ember's not bad. Still even heading in towards that OD. Really not anything still stopping them. They could go for like a 4-position Nyx or something on HellRaisers, but I don't think that would be a major concern. I'm kind of thinking about the HellRaiser pick as well in terms of like some sort of an active roamer. If you're thinking that the Witch Doctor is probably going to be hanging out in the bot lane with the Morphling, it's pretty reasonable to assume. There's no Earth Spear, but we still do have the Spirit Breaker as well as the Night Stalker. So they're going to get rid of the Bounty Hunter because they're a little worried about that one. That would have been the perfect one for the mid lane to pair up with the Puck. But I think either of those two heroes would also be good for trying to keep down this Invoker because you won't have too many rotations, obviously, from a Faceless Void. It'll just be about those Enchantress creeps. Maybe a Mirana would be good.
Kill off the Ench creeps with one arrow. I was looking at Tusk and kind of wondering if Tusk comes back into this, but he's not been a favored hero recently. Definitely not been up there at the pinnacle of picks and bans. HellRaisers, they do need someone to kind of bring this all together and definitely move between lanes. Undying is a hero, actually, that we haven't seen a hell of a lot of. It's going to be the Sand King. A hero that can
play. Agreed.
Well, he can play two roles. You know, you can go boots first, go stun people up, get to level 2, get to level 3 in the jungle, and then you farm through to the Blink Dagger. Tornado Rox, what we're looking at? Ember Spirit. Juggernaut is still out there. That's still a potential pick, actually, for them, if they do want to go down that route. But with a Faceless Void, you know, it's always a little bit rough picking a melee carry. Even with the Omni Slash being able to jump into the Chrono, you do want someone who can just sit outside and deal damage from a decent range.
I'm still just liking this OD. I don't see any reason why you wouldn't go for it right here. If it's a hero they want to pick, it doesn't look like it's something they've gone for too much recently, so maybe it won't be the hero here. So instead it'll just be a Chaos Knight. All right, you know, whatever then. Fine.
I mean, hello? What? Tron likes his... Wait, was Gyro banned out, actually? Did we talk about...
No, he wasn't.
Gyro wasn't picked or banned. Like
no, because I was even thinking, I wonder if HellRaisers could even think about taking the Gyro themselves as a roaming support just to deny it. That actually went through my head, and I was like, that sounds a little bit crazy, but no, it wasn't banned out there.
Interesting. Well, Chaos Knight it is then. Wow. Reduce the armor of Morphling. Decent in lane against Nature's Prophet, but We'll find out exactly what they're up to. They've got a decent old pushing lineup with the Enchantress CK. Well, HellRaisers destroying towers, even with a Nature's Prophet, can be a little bit risky and definitely not as efficient. That's what tornado.rox have to throw out at them. 5 seconds remaining. Honestly, I think this is down to laning phase. What happens in laning phase does not stay in laning phase. It's going to follow them and haunt them through the game.
You even, like, go... Where do you go with Tron? Does he go aggro and just run into this Morphling?
I have no idea. I have absolutely no idea. Because then...
Because they know they could just take free safe lane. Like, there's no way they can test the Nature's Prophet. Shasha will just get crushed by Chaos Knight plus one. I don't think Treants are going to save you against him.
Nope.
I like this. I like going aggro here with the Enchantress as well. Oh, this is so strong.
Oh, they're sending a bunch of people down there. And I guess with Sunstrike on top of the Chaos Bolt from the CK, that's a good amount of damage onto people. Well, Arzeek.
Yeah, they're not doing it. Boo.
It's not happening. Arzeek's Oracle is moving up towards the top lane. Boots first on the Oracle. Interesting stuff. So Yol picks up the majority of the support items there. Courier, wards. Well, actually, Arzeek bought the courier, but all the wards and everything else, as well as pooled tangos. Yol makes sure he gets them all out to everybody. Good early observe ward from the Nature's Prophet, though. Placed up a little further up than sometimes we do see. It's kind of in that middle point, right? Because people like to deward this area. They like to deward this area. Sometimes this ward can go unnoticed. Sometimes, but... quite often a sentry ward will be placed down here, and I'll get rid of that one. I'm just killing off Treants. Can you get it before it times out? 15 gold and 10 experience per person. tornado.rox off to a massive lead here already. The graph doesn't say shit, but we know it deep in our hearts that they're ahead.
Well, that's all that matters. So in terms of their vision, though, they will still have... This ward should be okay for the Faceless Void. He's going to have a relatively... okay time. That fairy fire is going to be pretty nice for Yola Warrior down here. Just chucking out all those right clicks on the Witch Doctor. Already a pretty annoying one to deal with in terms of the base damage. And now, you know, you're not a disruptor with Thunderstrike or anything, so it's not the best in terms of long-term harass or anything like that. But either way, it's not really something that you're going to be able to deal with using the time walk. Yeah, you can spam it out, but it's not major effective versus a lot of like those nukers you have to deal with. Oh, look at Treant. What a nuisance.
Maledict's not going to do anything to the Void. But Alpha Ninja mid, up the puck up against the Invoker. This lane's going to be relatively interesting. Alpha Ninja, you know, he's got the Null, he's got the Fairy Fire as well. Base damage, how are we actually looking? So that's 61 on the Invoker and 64 on the puck, so it's pretty damn close. It's going to be a tough old battle here towards the mid lane. BZZ up against Alpha.
Already yeah, he'll have the big advantage at level 2, though.
That's the Forge Spirit coming out. This is where it starts to get even trickier for the puck. The Slippery Devil has to keep right-clicking the Invoker down because you do have a regen advantage. Well, no you don't. There's salves on both of them. Never mind. So goddamn.
Yeah.
The smoke's anking.
With the face shift,
in
though.
With a stun. They're going to jump onto BZZ. It looks like he's going to die. Sunstrike is thrown out, but it's not going to save you, buddy. Good roam in, and that's goddamn. Boots anking. Level 1 Borrow Strike. He's almost up to level 2. Well, down the bottom lane, we just know. Ghost Stick is not going to get forced out of this lane.
Yeah, it's going to take a lot of right clicks. As long as he plays a creep wave well like he is right now, there's not much they can do.
Well, Illidan, he's shown in the past that he knows how to play the Morphling pretty well. Again, it's another roaming gank here, this time from tornado.rox. Dark Troll and Centaur. Up for the Enchantress, looking for the Nature's Prophet, but Chancellor, he's just waiting over to the wings. He knows something's up. He knows he can't go too aggressively into this, and this smoke's going to be wasted from y'all. I'll try and wrap in behind the tier 1 as this lane has pushed in pretty nicely. But can they dive? Seems relatively risky. And the smoke wears out as the Nature's Prophet Treant scouts him. So Shadow just walks himself back to tier 2. It's also perfectly timed. There will be a push in here with 1.5 waves plus the Ench creeps just to try and get some damage onto this tier 1.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I'm trying to think here, like... Who has Illidan been playing with this? He's been all over the place just in this one single patch because...
Power Rangers?
Yeah, Power Rangers. He was on Elements when this patch did start. so I don't even know how many teams he's played for. I mean, either way, it's always been this Morphling or Spectre or Animage. It's okay, everyone just accommodates to him.
And there's the fact that Tron used to play for Power Rangers too, right?
Oh, yeah.
tornado.rox dropped Sedoi and they picked up Tron. So maybe they're going to steal Illidan from Power Rangers as well. We'll find out, though. The shuffle, honestly, the shuffle is afoot. You know, Mammoth Boys will drop in players. We've had tornado.rox shuffling a little bit. There's a couple of other teams that definitely have shuffles in the works, but
well, he needs another bash down here.
Is he going
this is some really good trading.
Is Ivan dead? Oh, the fairy fire, ghost stick. 13 seconds until he's got the time walk. He can salve. I think he's okay with the poor man shield. He can salve up a couple of hits. There's another waveform in 3 seconds time. Oh, the final attack in. Tragic stuff.
No
Illidan barely getting in there with the kill.
Yeah, that's just bound to happen. Being forced in the poor man's shield just means he won't have the boots, and Illidan will just run him down. So that's perfect. You really need those early kills as a Morphling. It's what makes that major difference between your Evelade being something that's useful and being something that just feels kind of gimmicky. Whereas you just get it like 3 or 4 minutes earlier, and you're just like, oh yeah.
BZC mid.
Dota 2. Oh man, that's a lot of heroes.
He's just gone. He's done for. TP and Sharpslow for the experience and a little bit of the assist gold as well. But man, oh man, this Invoker's not having a good time. Roam in from this Sand King, and this is what we wanted, right? We wanted a hero that could just go roam onto mid constantly, and that's what Godham has given us. Perfect movement, perfect smokes. And they also managed to kind of balance this out with also shutting out Ghost Stick's Faceless Void, something that we kind of thought wouldn't happen. But he did go on a little bit of a streak running towards the Witch Doctor trying to get that kill. He definitely paid for it with his life. While Yol, on the other hand, this Enchantress is having a difficult time connecting with these rotations.
Yeah, and part of that, I think, is a lot because of Goddamn. Just the fact that he got that early level 1 kill in the mid lane, Sand King, probably one of the most reliant supports on getting that early kill. Like you said, like going boots either... I mean, if you don't get the Burrow Strike kill, it's so long before you get the kill into your Sandstorm, so you can actually get some more farm in the jungle. You kind of want the Caustic Finale even now because it accelerates your farm too. But he's just going right for the Tranquil Boots. He doesn't even want to jungle. Okay, he's going to grab right now, but... he's got quite a bit of movement speed to try and gank that mid lane once again. And with the Nature's Prophet, it's understandable. But just because of the start that he set, oh, look at them. Are they? Can they get this? This seems risky,
kill
just
him again. It looks like the damage output's good. There's BZZ just being right-clicked down. The silence, perfect.
Oh,
Mavon
nice.
And Jin, they're going to get a secondary one as well. Oh, Zeke, he's going to get stunned up by Godam. And even with Yol coming in, Alpha Ninja's still pretty freaking healthy. He jumps behind the Enchantress. Maybe looking for another re-engagement here. Godam needs to clarity up and get this mana flowing through. While Yol is still sitting by this tier 1, waiting, with a Faceless Void off the side. Still sitting at level 4.
He dodged it. Oh, the clap. That's too good. He actually dodged the underclap. I didn't think he was going to get it. But anyway, yeah, so Yol, you know, he finally shows up here. But generally with Enchantress, we've seen so many people come into like this dual offlane where rather than jungling up here where she is, like, you can kind of think, well, why isn't she down here jungling in here and helping out the Faceless Void? Because we've all seen how powerful these Satyr creeps and everything are, but with the threat of the Sand King being present possibly in the jungle, and you know that he got that early kill, so he could be anywhere between level 2 or 3, you're not really sure if he's hiding himself off the map, it's not as easy, because it's going to end up being a 2-on-3 rather than just this, like, 2-on-2 situation. So just that first, like, level 1 gank mid set up a lot of what's going on in this lane phase, and why the Enchantress hasn't felt that effective.
And look at this, Godam scouts out the Enchantress once more. Try to move in onto this mid lane. Puck is honestly close to unkillable right now. Without a Chronosphere, I do not think tornado.rox have enough stuns or enough ways to keep Puck actually held in place. So for the next 3-4 minutes or so, Alpha Ninja should be perfectly fine just free farming mid lane. Get closer to that Blink Dagger. You've got null treads. And there's no one who can withstand this in lane. That's why BZZ Invoker has moved towards the jungle just to farm up with Forge Spirits. And just keeping Illidan happily farming down in bottom lane. With Ivan, YOLO Warrior, just trying to stack and keep this jungle flowing. But Yol, he's now off lane Enchantress. 2 points and untouchable. tornado.rox just seem, I don't know, on the... Like, it's 7 minutes in, but they seem on their last legs. They're just trying desperately to scramble as much farm as they possibly can. Tron is the one hero who is comfortable at all in these lanes.
Yeah, he's going to be the one with the major impact coming in here probably in the next, I don't even know, 3 minutes or so. It feels like he needs to make some sort of a movement. Typically, you look for that Faceless Void, the first big chrono, but with the way the Invoker's been shut down here, I don't know if they're going to have enough to work inside of it with a Chaos Knight as their core. That'd be some very nice chronos that he can still get some attacks off, or at least follow-up stuns.
Well, for now, going a little bit static. HellRaisers are just keeping this vision up and good. Watching out for bot lane, trying to see where the Faceless Void is with that good old high ground ward up on the top of the little spire there. They're actually moving a few heroes towards the middle lane here. Chargeslow, I guess, can jungle now. He's shoved out the top lane pretty hard towards this tier 1. He's clear out a couple of jungle camps, and I'm looking at him and wondering. He's saved up 1,000 gold. Maybe he's not going to go for the Phase Boots Drums build just yet. Because we have seen Cheshire Cat over on Power Rangers still go for the good old Midas Shadowblade build up on Nature's Prophet.
Oh, yeah. That was pretty good, too. In a game like this, when you're snowballing so hard, I kind of like the Phase Drums. I think it would be a pretty solid choice just to group up and push down these towers. But if he wants to go for really early Orchid with how farmed he is, I think that would be sick. Up against the Enchantress, up against the Invoker, even up against the Faceless Void.
Get that Silver Edge. Kill everyone. I think that could work out pretty nicely. He's still looking at Goddam pretty far away from his blink, but his job in the first 9 minutes has definitely been a good one. Not been able to stack any camps for himself, though. Oh, tornado.rox, they're on the hunt. They are desperate for blood. But again, the Sand King scouts them out as they move on in. They know Enchantress is trying to wrap in from the side, and they're probably going to know. The hardcore push into this tier 1 with four heroes here from Rox isn't going to come to anything. Because Goddam can just place his Sandstorm down. What is there to stop him? What is there to stop this? There's no points in Wex from BZZ. He can Sunstrike, he can Ice Wall, but you can't stop the Sandstorm. Tier 1 is still dropping as Yol. Ah, there's the good old Phantasm, but TPs are coming through. The stun onto Tron with the Orb and Waning Rift, and Tron is dead. They'll keep him alive a little longer with the Oracle, but he's trapped in the Dream Coil, and man, oh man, tornado.rox is just crumbling apart right now. 7-0, 9.5 minutes in. This Invoker's on the runaway. And tier 1 gets denied.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
All right.
What do
well,
you do?
They achieved something here. You know, at one tower down. Considering the 7-0 disadvantage they're at here, you got to be something somewhat happy about that.
Map control, dude. It's all map control. It's part of the bigger plan. Dire's top tower is under attack. Oh, Illidan, this Morphling. He's going to be a beast
as well.
Oh, is he in trouble? Is under
attack. I thought so, but looks like Goddam doesn't have a friend here. They're too busy.
Nature's Prophet could potentially TP down here, as well as a Puck TP in. Puck's TP is on cooldown for 9 seconds. I think Goddam's just waiting, biding his time. If they can go now, though, with the Nature's Prophet TP into mid lane, there's no Ghost Walk, there's nothing to save BZZ, and they're going to go straight for it. This is a massive overextension from the Invoker. There's no reason to be this far up when you know there's a Nature's Prophet on the enemy team.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Sec. He needs a sec. Well, at the very least,
sure it's not just BM. I'm just gonna assume it's a BM pause.
Yeah, that means die, you bastard. Definitely. At the very, very least, tornado.rox. They're looking at the tier 1 down at bottom lane. They've got a level 4 Oracle. They're up against a level 9 Puck. Their net worth is not looking great, honestly. Even though they got those treant kills at the start, you know, they had themselves a good juicy lead and the game was pretty much over from then. Their net worth and experience, it hasn't gone well. Hasn't gone well at all. 5,000-6,000 net worth lead and a good 3,000-4,000 experience lead here for HellRaisers, as every lane belongs to them. Arzeke's trying to get some aggressive wards towards the Radiant Jungle. But what's that going to accomplish? You'll try and see the Sand King. Try and keep vision over on the Nature's Prophet, who did go for the Phase Boots, actually. Phase Boots and now maybe back into the Midas. But I think tornado.rox need a few Midases of their own.
Yeah, that's always the question right here, isn't it? It's like, do I go for it? And in terms of the Chaos Knight, he just wants that armlet up. I think they just need to gear up for one fight in about 2 or 3 minutes and just win it. And that'll bring them right back into this game. You know, you have your armlet up, you got your Chronosphere, Enchantress has Impetus, she can start chucking those out, maybe get her treads up to improve the DPS. But it's on the burden of HR right now. They just can't let that happen. Don't even take a fight. Like, they have nothing to gain from fighting if they can avoid it. If they can just keep split pushing the side lanes with Nature's Prophet and the Morphling, single pickoffs are not going to be enough to bring this back for Rox.
Yeah, as long as Elizabeth can do this, freely takes a tier 2. TP's back down, bot lane is pushed in for him to farm. It's all so perfect for Illidan's Morphling. And what did tornado.rox get out of that smoke? Not even Roshan. They are 3-man jungling right now. Invoker, Enchantress, and Oracle are both hanging out in the Dire Jungle with Tron, K- Chaos Knight up at top. You've got 12-minute Midas on Invoker. Things aren't looking so bad. Armlet's nearly done for Tron CK. They do have this brawling power in the next couple of minutes, like you said, with the Chrono as well. If they can just catch HellRaisers out. But with the lines drawn on the map, I think HR, they realize this predicament that they could be putting themselves in. It's just time to get some vision up. As long as you can see Tornado Rox, that initiation tool that they have with the Void.
Oh, yeah.
It's not going to come through.
Puny. So, and now is a great time for them to actually take a team fight if they are all grouped up, too, just because they have the Blink Dagger now and Alpha Ninja, so Puck's going to be like a hero now. It's like, basically, Puck has two phases. It's like, win your lane, but then if you don't have your Blink coming out of that lane, that there's that awful stage where you're just, like, useless. You're like something like a larva in a cocoon, essentially. You feel like you can't do all that much until you actually have the Blink Dagger, and you're like, okay, now this feels like I can do something. That's, they're all ready to go. And they could even look for Roshan themselves, honestly, just by having that Prophet.
Oh, man.
That's an easy kill.
Ghost Stick. Oh, man. Oh, they were trying to save the tier 1 with a TP in and a Chronosphere, but Tornado Rox, they're just not on the same page. There's a couple of heroes still sitting mid trying to shove this out, but Sand King was in the perfect spot, just waiting. And Alpha Ninja, are you pretending to be an illusion because he's going to jump straight in onto the support? She catches them both with the Dream Coil. Yol will attempt a TP out, but Tron is caught with the Epicenter as well. Phantasm's through, tries to get the jump, but look at the sprout from that Nature's Prophet. 12-0 at 13 minutes. Maybe 13-0 here soon as BZZ's jumped on by the Puck. Tornado Rox, what did you do to deserve this?
I guess this is just one of those scenarios where you lose every lane. I don't even know if they lost top. I guess top was kind of a non-factor, though. It's just all that pressure applied to the mid lane on the Invoker. You know, he was feeling the hate, and then the bottom lane couldn't really get all that much out of it. Not going for the early Iron Talon as well just meant that Ghosta couldn't start this recovery a little bit sooner. You know, like, he kind of had to keep going back there because all he had was the poor man's shield, so jungling is just going to be equally as slow in most senses, so... And again, you know, you're giving Illidan his Morphling, and 13-minute Lincolns is never gonna come out too well for you. Oh, that's no fun.
That's so sad.
that happens, man. That's just some
so
Morphling gaming.
Sad. Now they're all gonna die. Alpha Ninja jumps forward onto the Illusory Orb, and Illidan is just tanking through everything with another Dream Coil. They've caught them all, and Tornado Rox. Can they even kill the Morphling? He's just running from low ground to high ground. Oh, man. They got the replica. They got the Morphling Illusion with the Sunstrike Chrono combo, but that just makes me so sad to watch, honestly. 17-0. 15 minutes in. Have we ever seen a game? Actually, yes, we have. There was the ESL one Frankfurt.
22-0.
22-0 IG against EG, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yep.
That's the gold standard. I'm sure there's been worse as well, but it's one of those bigger ones that sticks out. There was another, I know there was a, what was it, 13-minute stomp yesterday in Captain's Draft between Alliance and DC. I believe Alliance ran them over with a Leshrac that just got completely out of control in the mid lane from S4. He got like a triple kill at 3 minutes or something and just had Bloodstone up. Coming in at like the 12-minute mark, and then that was pretty much it. So, it's along those lines right now. 17-0.
Puck is making a Dagon as well. Oh god.
That's the item. That's so the
oh
item.
God, he's just gonna kill everyone. Tornado Rox. I don't know, boys. I don't know about this, lads. You got. Oh, I got Midas on Invoker. You've got the Faceless Void running around. 30 seconds till Chrono. You'll smoke up here, but you've missed out on Tron. Oh, dearie me. Dearie me. Mop packs. They're trying to go Roche. They're trying to sneak
this is definitely what you have to do, but Alpha Ninja, oh, please don't scout. That's all they can say. It's like, please, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. All right, they're clear. They're good.
322-0 is the dream, by the way. Oh, the Invoker, at least he's got Alacrity up. They're taking Roshan down at a reasonable rate. Y'all's tanking through it with his Untouchable.
Oh, can you imagine if the Courier went through? That would have been so funny. It was actually so cool. Alpha Ninja, he's going to go in. Oh, he's orbited!
Orb. He knows. He doesn't know. He doesn't know, but he's gonna blink in and get a triple kill. Blink in. Go for it. Do it. Oh, they don't go in. Good Roshan. Tornado Rox. They've got something to their name. Good amount of levels. Good amount of gold. Invoker has the Aegis. Good stuff. Good stuff. It's a step. It's a tiny, tiny baby step. It's a step an amoeba would make, you know? a single molecular step. I'm not sure how far it'll get them, but regardless...
Kill!
Wait, what? No, they got one!
He died!
They got one! Shit, I got the Witch Doctor. I missed that, I wasn't expecting it. Well, that's a bigger step. They've killed someone. How much gold was that, actually? Oh, not a massive amount.
I mean, it was only the Witch Doctor.
But, dude, honestly, come on. There's a 14k net worth lead here 17 minutes in. I was expecting something bigger. I was expecting, like, 3,000 gold to be swung there to the Invoker, you know? Give him something. Throw him a bone. Okay. Well, Sand King's got his blink. And HellRaisers, they've stepped off the gas for a little second here. They've given away a bit. Go stick. He's got money. No, he doesn't. He doesn't have anything.
Illidan's current GPM. he's gonna have an E-blade at 20 minutes. With Lincoln Sphere.
600 GPM. Not bad. Not too shabby.
What about 22 actually at this point? So he should be okay. He should be pretty happy with that, I think, you know.
Yeah, with the 11,000
net worth. Look at this Hawk bait up here. This is greasy. Do they have a ward?
Is it a bait or is it just a jump in? It's just a jump in.
Just a jump in this time.
Oh, they haven't killed him yet. There we go. Take him out. Take down the Enchantress. Greasy, filthy Enchantress picker. Still a wonderful little hero. Tron, Ogre Club up, trying to get into the BKB, I think. A high ground push here for HellRaisers isn't necessarily simple, though. They need to win a team fight outside of the base. They do still need someone who can go and stand high ground, which isn't really Morphling, honestly. You know, Nature's Prophet Treants might be able to do it, as he's glitching out in the jungle, shoving these troops around with Sprout. But yeah, with Chrono and Invoker combo here, tornado.rox can actually defend high ground reasonably well.
Yeah, but at the same time, you're just giving all this map space here over to Illidan. And as a Morphling, he'll be more than happy about that. It's like, yeah, you guys can go ahead, have some decent high ground defense, but I'm Illidan Morphling. Eventually, I'm going to come at you with such monstrosities that you'll have no idea what to do. That kill picked up as well, he's going to have the E-Blade in, like, just a minute.
Oh, boy. He's level 14 as well. What's going on?
Got him.
Chrono catches him, and here's another kill. Sunstrike Zap. 18 to 2.
Oh, the gem. That's huge.
It's a big old swing. Well, there's another 1,000 gold swing for tornado.rox. Who got the gem? Is it Enchantress?
The Oracle has it.
Oh, cool. Okie dokie.
Oh. Just picked it up off of a... Oh, and poor Yolo Warrior was even the one who bought it, too. Just gave it to his Sand King in good faith, you know?
Witch Doctor and Sand King, they're the feeders here. HellRaisers getting a little bit away, but just look at Alpha Ninja. He's hunting on the back end, looking for a jump in and pick off. But it's a good grouping here. tornado.rox, making sure they're not going to get whammed by the little wombo combo that Alpha Ninja... Wait. Puck. Puck, what are you doing?
I mean, can they kill him?
He's just hasting around. There's no one to stop him.
Morphling coming in. Oh, Illidan? Oh, yeah, he just missed that. He activated his TP for a second. First, he's like, oh, wait, oops. And switches the E-Blade slot and kills the Enchantress.
Faceless Void, we just stood there looking at the Enchantress, wondering, what can I do? What can I do to stop this? Still building into the Vladimirs. Goodness gracious me, and a Yule Scepter 20 minutes in. The Puck, Dagon 1, Blink Yules. We're having a pretty damn good time. So, do HellRaisers wait for next Roshan here? Is that what they're aiming for? Get Roshan and end the game. Because they're being awfully timid with the way they're playing this. They're not grouping up, they're not balling down a lane as 5. They aren't particularly aggressively split pushing a lane either. Oh, have they got him? Death Ward? That wasn't the best combo. A couple of spells utilized there by HellRaisers, not the best efficiency, but tornado.rox, they get that Chaos Knight away and back to safety. But yeah, there's no aggressive split pushing here from HellRaisers. It's kind of just we're wandering around doing what we want, farming away.
And I don't even know, because you have a Witch Doctor and you have the Sand King, and the Sand King's kind of ready to go high ground. He's already got his Blink Dagger, but you know, Ivan, he's just kind of happy here on his Witch Doctor. He's like, you know, I'd love some, maybe Nags or Do we really have to end it right now, guys? I don't really feel like I'm contributing.
I want to be a witch doctor with items. They got a gem back. Sad. Ghost stick.
He didn't get it mid dive.
He did get the gem, but he jumps himself away. Dreamcaller is still there, and Yule Scepter up the tornado. Meteor even. Does land down onto a couple of people's heads, and Tron obliterates YOLO Warrior. The Witch Doctor's dead, and this maybe is where Tornado Rox can start fighting relatively easily, but it's a good face shift with another Burrow Strike. Deafening Blast is out, and Illidan, he's clearing people up with these E-Blade zaps. Another face Jump shift through. Again. It's not going to be 3-2-2. It's going to be 23-4 as they use the Invoker back up into the air with the damage output. They've got this no gem and no reveal. And in goes Tron again. He's back into the fight. The double buyback. Illidan, he's morphing. The strength gain is just inevitably going to allow him out. The TP, there's no stuns. There's nothing to hold him in until the cold snap. Yep, got him. Godlike streak taken. And now a Yule Step drop onto Puck. Phase shift orb. Jump away. Back to safety. But Tornado Rox, they get themselves another 3 kills. And fight recap, even with the 2 buybacks, they get away with a 2,400 gold gain. Wow. Defending high ground is pretty good as well, you know?
Just CK bought back and made 287 gold. That's how far behind they are. Okay, well, I don't know if you wanted it to go on the Enchantress, perhaps a little bit unfortunate. Obviously, she has like a great artillery cannon, but I feel like you just need BKB or something on this CK, so then he becomes a monster, and he would have had it with that, but it's all right. They'll have a little bit of space to farm it up now. They need to look for another one of the sneaky Roches next, I think.
I just want to give the CK a BKB. Can I just go to the shop and drag it into his inventory, please?
He's dead.
This is tragic. BZZ in trouble.
He's going to get healed.
Alpha Ninja. Dropping low, but Godam's Epicenter will clear up a couple there. Ghost Stick, Time Walk ready in 2 seconds. Is he going to be able to escape with the silence up? It doesn't look like he's got a great chance, but there's no further follow-up. No Blitz stun from Godam. He's going to stun up the creeps, apparently. Screw mana conservation. Kill creeps. Where's Illidan? Where's Illidan? Who cares? Where's Illidan? Alpha Ninja just jumps straight on and dodges the stun with a phase shift. BZZ buys back, but Illidan. Invoker. I think this Morphling has your number.
Oh, he's so ready to jump right now. Where are you? Where are you?
He doesn't insta-kill y'all. Close.
Oh, that's disappointing. Boo. Value drums, strength treads.
Oh, that's right. He has tanked up a fair amount. Earned strength treads and drums. All keeping him pretty happy right now. Goddamn, an alpha. They've smoked up. Looking towards top because Ghost Stick. He's farming outside of his base. You walk down the ramp and you put yourself in a pretty rough spot. He even jumps forward looking for the chrono here, but the stun side. Void's gone. There's no point even naming the spells they use because he's just obliterated. Tornado Rox, without your Void, without that chrono, you do not have the setup stun that you need for this Invoker to land his combination. What does Invoker have right now? Blink, Yule's Midas, no Aghanim Scepter. He needs to start invoking these spells. Use Alacrity, get the meatball down as Illidan. Oh, Yule, very nearly dead again. But Alpha Ninja will secure it with a Dagon Blink. The meatball doesn't do a damn thing. Goddamn, does. 28-5. Is this going to be our final score? Are we going to see more death, more destruction? Taking down the lane of Rax. Honestly, for Tornado Rox. Everyone understands why they're waiting this long to call GG, right? They don't want to be the team that has that 12-minute GG. They don't want to be the team that lost in under 20 minutes. They want to see if they can get themselves back into the game, but they do tap out now as HellRaisers. Well, honestly, they won that game in the first 10 minutes.
Yeah, that just... I don't know. They had obviously a very early aggressive lineup with the Puck, the Nature's Prophet, the Sand King being really active. That was really great to see, wasn't it? Actually seeing a Sand King doing a lot, I think... A lot of times with Sand King, it falls off. You mess up that first Burst Strike gank, you don't get the kill, then you end up falling back to the jungle after leeching level 2 and sometimes even 3 from your safe lane, and then it feels like he just never comes online. And if the game drags out long enough, yeah, maybe he does some stuff, but goddamn, was really active. He got up the Blink Dagger nice and early, then moved right into a Tranquil Boots Soul Ring, was his kind of roaming around build that he did, and with the help of Shashla, you can understand why it would be so effective. And then Illidan just got to farm and half a ninja, man. Good player.
Well, that wraps it up for CIS Dota for today. We'll be back in a little while. 1 hour until EUS games kick off. Wombat against Liquid, and who's the other game? Prius against someone else.
I want to say LC, but is that right?
I don't think it is. It's Samurai. Samurai Champloo is the.
Oh, Champloo! That's Attacker's team.
Yep. Attacker, Garter, a moment.
I heard Black standing in for them. Ooh. I don't know if that's today, though.
Nice.
I hope so.
Excellent. I know a moment and Garter. They've got a couple of other names I don't recognize, but Attacker, obviously. The famous Kunkka player. 7K, 7.3K, something like that. But yep, we will be back in 1 hour with the US games.